الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، وصلى الله وسلم بارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فقد وصلنا ولله الحمد في كتاب العقيدة الواسطية لشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية شرح محمد بن صالح بن عثيمين رحمه الله إلى التكلم عن الفرق التي ظهرت في أول الإسلام وكيف انقسمت وما هي العقيدة التي هم عليها. So we made it excuse me last week alhamdulillah into the beginning of breaking down the various groups and what their methodologies and their belief system, where did they differ, because now we've established that everybody agrees about the tawheed of rububiyyah, the lordship, now even non-Muslims, and all Muslims predominantly agree to the tawheed al-uluhiyyah, meaning Allah should be the only object of worship, except those who have worshipped graves and other than Allah, or those who have deviated tremendously like the Shia and others who have made Ali a god and what have you, as we mentioned, like the Khawarij in the early times. But the major aspect of tawheed which the Muslims differ about until today tremendously excuse me, is tawheed al-asma wa sifat, the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh rahimahullah says, فَانْقَسَمُوا فِي أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ إِلَى أَقْسَامٍ مُتَعَدِّدَةٍ قِسْمٌ قَالُوا. So they have divided in terms of the names and attributes of Allah into a number of groups, number of divisions. A group of them said, لَا يَجُوزُ أَبَدًا أَن نَصِفَ اللَّهَ لَا بِوُجُودٍ وَلَا بِعَدَمٍ لأنه إذا إن وصف بالوجود أشبه الموجودات، وإن وصف بالعدم أشبه المعدومات، وعليه يجب نفي الوجود والعدم عنه. Look at this crazy stuff. We call it crazy because it is crazy. A group of them said, it is not permissible to describe Allah as existing. You cannot say Allah exists. Furthermore, you cannot say that Allah is non-existing. You cannot say that Allah doesn't exist. Huh? You cannot say Allah exists. You cannot claim that Allah exists, and you cannot claim that Allah is non-existent. Because if you describe Him, or if you claim that Allah exists, then you are comparing Allah to the other existing things. And that shouldn't be done according to their intellect. Now if they put the Quran aside, and they put the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ on the other side, these are people who are using Greek philosophy and philosophers who came and introduced this ilm al-kalam, known as ilm al-kalam. Many Sufis are famous for that, the knowledge of speech, and it's based on philosophy and intellect, although these people have lost their intellect, yet they want to understand Allah according to mind, not realizing that the people indeed vary in their understanding, and the minds of people are not the same. And Allah Azza wa Jal had made a variation among His creation in terms of understanding. That's why He revealed something that is the basis, that is textual evidence, which which does not negate intellect, and which could be the reference when there's difference, not what individuals understand. So this is very fundamental, because they say if you describe Allah as existing, then you are comparing Him to other existing things. And if you claim that, if you describe Him as non-existent, then you are comparing Allah to the non-existent things, things that don't exist. And because of that, according to them, you should negate both existence and non-existence to Allah. So you cannot say, if somebody says, does Allah exist? According to them, you cannot say yes. And if somebody says, is Allah non-existent? According to them, you cannot say yes either. Where do you go? Huh? Where is it? This is mystery, man. وَمَا ذَهَبُوا إِلَيْهِ فَهُوَ تَشْبِيهٌ لِلْخَالِقِ بِالْمُمْتَنِعَاتِ وَالْمُسْتَحِيلَاتِ. And basically what the methodology or the path that they have traveled upon is that it is comparing Allah to things that are impossible. Comparing Allah to impossible things. لأن تقابل العدم والوجود تَقَابُلِ نَقِيدَيْنِ, because the opposition of existent and non-existent is the opposition of two things that are opposite to each other. يعني they contradict one another. وَالنَّقِيدَانِ لَا يَجْتَمِعَانِ وَلَا يَرْتَفِعَانِ, and the things that contradict each other, they cannot be combined and they cannot rise. وكل عقول بني آدم تنكر هذا الشيء ولا تقبله. He says, and all the minds of the son of the children of Adam refuse that thing, and it does not accept it. So look how they try to run away from something, and they fell into something that is much more evil than the original thing. So they try to run away from comparing Allah to His creation. They wind up going into a path that is much much more evil than what they thought they were running away from, by negating the attributes of Allah and saying that Allah doesn't exist. And Allah says, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. It is Allah, there is no God worthy of worship but He, the living. To them now you have an issue with these attributes, because you cannot describe Allah as being someone as existing, as an existing being. This is the first group. وقسم آخر قالوا نصفه بالنفي ولا نصفه بالإثبات, يعني أنهم يجوزون أن تسلب عن الله سبحانه وتعالى الصفات لكن لا تثبت. The other group said, we only describe Allah with negation, but we will not describe Him with any affirmation. What does that mean? What that means, it is okay to describe Allah with negating attributes. For example, لم يلد, he never begets. طيب, this is a لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم, no sleep or slumber overtakes him. Any attribute of negation, they believe. Any attribute of affirming الرحمن الرحيم, they don't accept. Huh? Because they are confirming the attribute of Allah. Anything that affirms the attribute of Allah, they say we cannot accept it. But anything that negates it, no problem with that. Huh? You understand what I'm saying? So all the attributes in the Quran that describe Allah in terms of negating, لم يكن له كفوا أحد, and there is none equal to Him, this is negating. The kind of description here is negating that Allah has nothing that is equal to Him عز وجل. They accept that. But Allah As-Samad, they don't accept that, because the first one is affirming the attribute of absolute, As-Samad, the absolute, according to one interpretation. But they cannot accept. But they can accept, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ, and He is no equal to Him. Why? Because He has no equal. The fact that there is no negating, they accept. Anything that affirms, they do not accept. يعني لا نقول هو حي إنما نقول ليس بميت. So we do not say Allah is alive, rather we say Allah is not dead. You cannot say Allah is alive, hay, but you can say Allah is not dead. So the second one they accept. Why? Because لا يموت, أفوان, ليس بميت, He is not dead. The fact that there's He is not, they like that. They like that. They like that aspect of negation. But to affirm it, هو الحي, oh no, can't go there. طيب, ولا نقول عليم بل نقول ليس بجاهل, الله المستعان. And we don't say Allah is the most knowledgeable, rather we say Allah is not ignorant. They cannot affirm that Allah is most knowledgeable, but they can say Allah is not ignorant. Why? Because there's negation. وهكذا, and such. وقالوا لو أثبت له شيئا شبهته, لو أثبت له شيئا شبهته بالموجودات. Because if you confirm and affirm an attribute of Allah, then you are comparing Him to the creation. You are comparing Him to things that already exist, like our attributes. You say you are alive, huh? You have basar, you are basir. You have sama', you are sami', and what have you. So they're trying to run away from comparing Allah to His creation. Again, they fell into something that is more evil, where they wind up negating and denying the Quran. Allah calls Himself in the Quran, هو الله الحي, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. Allah calls Himself with this. How are you going to say no? أعوذ بالله. لأنه على زعمهم كل الأشياء موجود الأشياء الموجودة متشابهة. Because according why they doing this? Because according to them, all things that exist, everything that exists, they have they are similar. All existing things are similar. So if you compare Allah, if you also attribute to Allah attributes of affirming, then you are comparing Allah to the rest of the creation which have which are existing. Again, it's a lot of philosophy. If you don't understand it, good. You don't need to understand يعني something that doesn't make sense. If you do and you can understand it and know the truth, excellent. If this is not making sense to you, no problem, because it doesn't make sense in reality. It's a bunch of people that are just trying to overwork themselves for nothing.
Like they said, that too much knowledge is dangerous.
Yeah, well, in this case, yes, because it's knowledge that Allah didn't reveal. Otherwise, too much knowledge of Islam is never dangerous. That's good, yeah. But too much knowledge of things that Allah didn't reveal, Allahu musta'an. طيب. فأنت لا تثبت له شيئا وأما النفي فهو عدم مع أن الموجود في الكتاب والسنة في صفات الله من الإثبات أكثر من النفي بكثير. So they said you do not affirm anything to Allah, but it's okay to negate. You negate. He said فهو عدم مع أن so he said and the interesting thing is that the description in the Quran and the Sunnah of the attributes of Allah, those that affirm are much, much more than those that negate. Huh? Because you say, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم. All these are affirming. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر. Affirming, 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 affirming. Then you will find somewhere along the lines, ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Huh? And other attributes of negation. You will, in comparison, the book Quran and the Sunnah, predominantly it's affirming the attributes of Allah, much more than negating. So according to them, you wind up rejecting the majority of the Quran, because you only believe in the little few examples where Allah Azza wa Jal described Himself in the sense of negation. We will see some examples, inshallah, as we go through the book. طيب. قيل لهم إن الله قال عن نفسه سميع بصير. It was said to them, these so-called intelligent people, Allah called Himself in the Quran سميع بصير. He is all hearing, all seeing. Right? It's in the Quran. قالوا هذا من باب الإضافات. بمعنى نسب إليه السمع. لا لأنه متصف به. They said this is from, this is an example of just additions. This is just an addition. They said meaning, We add to Allah Azza wa Jal hearing, but it doesn't mean that Allah has that quality. We say that Allah hears, but it doesn't mean that Allah has the quality of hearing. Again, twisted minds. ولكن لأن له مخلوقا يسمع. But because he has some sort of creation that hears, so he hears through that. فهو من باب الإضافات. So it is just a matter of addition. فسميع يعني ليس له سمع لكن له مسموع. So سميع to them, it doesn't mean that Allah has a hearing ability. Rather they say that He has the means to hear. يعني going around like this. وجاء الطائفة الثانية, another group said, قالوا هذه الأوصاف لمخلوقاته وليست له. أما هو فلا يثبت له صفة. الله المستعان. Another group said, these attributes are only for His creation. As for Allah, we do not affirm any attribute. We do not affirm that Allah is Sami' and Basir. يعني some of them did ta'wil. They try to interpret it a certain way where they kind of get by. A part of them, a group of them, they were straight up. They said, no, 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 Habibi. Sami' Basir, no way. No way Allah is all hearing, all seeing. Only the creation. Only us. We are all hearing, all seeing. As for Allah, they cannot accept that. They do not affirm that. Second group. Third group. وقسم ثالث قالوا يثبت له الأسماء دون الصفات وهؤلاء هم المعتزلة أثبتوا أسماء الله قالوا إن الله سميع بصير قدير عليم حكيم لكن قدير بلا قدرة سميع بلا سمع بصير بلا بصر عليم بلا علم حكيم بلا حكمة لا إله إلا الله. A group, a third group said, we affirm to Allah only the name but not the attribute. Only the name but not the actual attribute. And these are the Mu'tazila. They are called the Mu'tazila. They affirm the names of Allah. So they say Allah is all hearing, all seeing, all capable, all knowledgeable and all wise, but Allah is